How y'all doing today? It's your boy Eat Right Guy. And for this video, it's gonna be a little off topic. It's not really gonna involve nutrition or fitness. It's gonna be kind of a motivational video. And I'm gonna pretty much share some of my personal experiences. And this is dedicated to all the recent college graduates. It's the end of May. A lot of people are graduating. A lot of dietetic interns are finishing up their internships and they're trying to get out in the world and find their first job so they can get experience. And unfortunately, there's not a lot of jobs around, and this is with any kind of field. And you don't work real hard for at least 4 years to get your degree, and a lot of people are not going to be able to get a job or get the job of their dreams in the field that they want. But that doesn't mean that you won't get that opportunity later on in life. And you don't want to get discouraged and feel that, oh, I majored in the wrong thing, or things aren't working the way I want them to be. And so just want to share my experiences once I got out of my internship and finished school and my transition to where I'm at now in my career. And so I did 4 years of college, and after that, I had to do my internship, which is 9 months. And we graduate in May. So I know the school that I went to is, I think their graduation is in 2 weeks. But leading up, probably like around in April, I started applying for jobs. And I knew I wanted to stay in the South. If I could stay in Louisiana, that would be preferable, but I was open to moving to Georgia and Florida or Texas. Those were the three states. And so I applied for like probably over 100 different positions. I remember in the state of Florida, I applied for every dietitian position in the state of Florida at that time. I went on like monster.com, indeed.com, pretty much all different search engines. I didn't get no responses. None. Absolutely none. And then after like my internship, I think I got like one response, and it was pretty much saying that I guess I didn't have enough experience because I didn't have any experience. I'm just finishing my internship and I wasn't a dietitian yet. So I was kind of getting discouraged because people in my class, a few of them were getting jobs lined up in the states that they came from. So I was getting discouraged. So, in Louisiana, one of the places where I did my internship at, where I did a rotation at, they had a job opening. And I did like 4 weeks total. I did 2 weeks of clinical there, 4 weeks, 2 weeks of food service. I liked the food service manager. I liked the hospital. The hospital is about 45 minutes from my house, but I was like, you know what? I'm just desperate for a job. I just need some type of opportunity. I interviewed for the job, and it came down between me and this other intern. And this intern, she did her internship at a different school, but she did like 80% of her internship at that one hospital. So they knew her really well. And it came down to me and her. I did my in-person interview, and they ended up choosing her. And that messed me up right there. I really thought I was gonna get that job. Then they had a hospital that was closer to my house, which is actually, I think, the largest hospital in Louisiana. This hospital, actually, I did 8 weeks there in my internship. So, no, more than 8 weeks. I did 4 weeks food service, 6 weeks clinical. So, 10 straight weeks, 10 weeks total. And that was my favorite. The clinical there was my favorite rotation, period. Throughout the whole dietetic internship. Like, after I finished that rotation, I was like, I definitely want to do clinical and I want to specialize in nutrition support. And I liked all the dietitians, I liked the hospital, I liked the charting system, but they didn't have any open positions. But they did have a diet tech, a PRN diet tech position, which a diet tech is pretty much like a step under a dietitian. All you have to do is get like an associate's degree, and they don't get paid as much and they don't have the same responsibilities. And they were telling me, one of the dietitians I was working at the hospital, it was like, hey, you need to think about being a diet tech. You know what I'm saying? We have this position open. We need the help. We'd like for you to be part of the team. And I'm just thinking to myself, like, I went through all this school. I'm not about to be a diet tech. You know what I'm saying? I want to get paid as a dietitian. I want to present myself as a dietitian, not a diet tech. And then it's PRN, so I'm not even guaranteed any hours. And so I was getting really frustrated. Still wasn't getting any calls back or any emails back from the places that I applied. And I was like, man. And at the time, I was working at Walmart. I worked at Walmart for 6 years. I started my senior year of high school all the way through college and my internship. And I'm making like $10 an hour at work at Walmart. And I'm just sick and tired of working there. And so eventually I talked to my mom and she convinced me to take the diet tech position. Because even though I was getting paid $10 at Walmart, the diet tech position was paying me like $12 an hour. So I was like, I might as well just take this position. It's PRN, it's short term. And at least I'm making $2 extra an hour compared to Walmart. And I'm getting a little experience. And so, little did I know, the reason why that dietitian was telling me to apply for that position was because one of the dietitians was leaving. So they couldn't really tell me all that, but they knew they liked me as an intern, and they knew if I got this position, it was gonna be an easy process to transition me from a diet tech to a dietitian. And so that's what ended up happening. I was only a diet tech for 2 weeks before I got promoted to a dietitian at the hospital that I loved, at the position that I wanted. And it was closer to my house. So even though I was discouraged to not get that first job at that hospital 45 minutes from my house, an opportunity came about that was even better than that. And so for all y'all, I speak about dietitians a lot. That's because that's my profession. I had the most experience. For the interns that's getting out, but just because you don't get your initial job isn't what you want it to be, just keep being open-minded. Even if you can't find a job, just keep at it and keep at it. Things are gonna happen. Just don't get discouraged. Take an opportunity. If you get a job opportunity to be a dietitian, even if you don't like it, just think about taking it for the experience. You can always find another job. And you never know, you may like your position, it may open up other doors to something that is better in the future. So hopefully this video inspires some of y'all with my story, and y'all have a nice day.